Everybody, welcome back to Barf Plays Banjo-Kazooie. This, Banjo-Kazooie, is a game where I play as Banjo and Kazooie. I collect jigsaw puzzle pieces in order to destroy a witch, and then... Whoa! Against every anti-Semitism has followed? Against every anti-Semitism, welcome to the party. Thanks for playing, welcome to the game. My brain alert looked like it might have been a little bit squished there, and if it was, I apologize for that. We collect puzzle pieces in order to destroy a witch so that we can save our sister. It's your basic video game plot. We've all seen it 1,000 times. That's what I thought. Okay. Okay. See, now this is where I need to go as Crocodile Guy. But I had to break the ice first. How much does a polar bear weigh? Just enough to break the ice. Hi, I'm Barf. I'm happy about this. Oh, that's right. I had it a little backwards. I had it a minute amount of backwards. You can get through Bubble Gloop Swamp all the way through. But Freeze Easy Peak has a race. See, I knew that the Crocodile game... had the sneakers. But I need the sneakers also for the Freeze Easy Peak race, and I don't get them until Gobi Desert. That's the secret. That's the magic. Are the golden feathers enough to use the swamp route? Maybe. But I'm stingy with my golden feathers. I really am. I am only talking to her because I suspect that if I do, she will give me health. Because I've already talked to this one already. Yay! You poor dears, your energy is low. Let me fill it up for you. Thank you. Oh. Grunty's legs and stomach thins. Goodbye to all those double chins. Hey, you know what? She's on the power hot diet, and so am I. If I could borrow a phrase from Day 9. Trying to get power hot. Not always easy. But it's definitely the goal. Yeah, that's right. And this gets me free shit. Get in there. It's a slam basket dunk. To use a sports ball metaphor. There we go. Much better. Oh! If I jump too early, I'm gonna get eaten by a piranha. Alright, nope, I'm good. Totally good. Gonna instead fly around in, you know, how do you have it there? The, battlefield time? Awesome! I'm not a battlefield player. But I do appreciate that game for existing, which I guess is about the vaguest, most useless thing a person can say about a game. Thank you for hanging out, I really appreciate it. Freeze Easy Peak is over here, I think? Perhaps, maybe? Okay. I found it. Do I use glitches for this run? Nope. For two reasons. First of all, I think glitching is cheating, and I am not a cheatist. Secondly, I don't know any glitches. I don't. I know they. I'm sure they exist. They exist for all of my favorite games for some reason or another, but I don't know any of them. There we go. My goal for this is the same as it is for my Mario 64 run, which is to find all the things. But as far as, like, speedrunning... Yeah, that's right, their dad's missing. I gotta, what do I gotta do? I think I gotta crash him in the stomach. I think that's what I gotta do. Feels like the sort of thing I would do. Anything? Nothing? Okay. Stomach aches? I shouldn't have eaten that shiny thing. Someone help poor Boggy. Bam! Oh yeah, no, I gotta do the, I gotta do the sled thing. I gotta lay my sled on his ass. Oh shit! Fuck off! Oh yeah, I need to be able to bomb those dudes too. So I gotta go to Gobi Desert. Where's the map to Gobi Desert? It's not easy to find fair gamers for a Banjo-Kazooie stream. Is that right? I'm not super familiar with, like, what the current Banjo-Kazooie gaming climate is like. I just know that it has been advised to me by professional streamers, but also by what my experience is when I find a streamer that I like, that it's a good idea to have... Maybe not necessarily a specialty, but, like, a thing that somebody can easily say, oh, him, he does this. Like, I've got friends who are, you know, they stream space and sci-fi games. I know people who are, oh, I stream shooter games. I stream Hearthstone, you know, whatever it is their thing is. And it makes it real easy to, like, create a brand and market themselves. Not that I'm super into doing that all that much, but it is nice to be able to say, oh, what do? I'm a variety retro streamer. And then just, that's it. So then I get to choose, oh, this week I want to play Super Mario Brothers. I want to play The Legend of Zelda. I want to play, you know, Banjo-Kazooie. And then when I'm not doing this, I also have the freedom to do other things. But, you know, you don't have to always stick to the thing you say you're going to do. But it's nice to have a focus. And I decided that since I have a problem and can't stop playing old games, I may as well do it in such a way that if somebody was interested in watching, they could help, they could come in and chill out. Seemed like it made sense. Besides which, I have a lot of these games. Like, I don't have a lot of modern games. I've never been much... I've never been much of a, you know, gotta buy it right when it comes out kind of guy. Actually, that's not necessarily true. I have bought a lot of games right when they came out, but not recently, I haven't. Fuck. So what I mean by that is, you know, I put myself in a situation where, oh, I want to stream games, but also as far as, like, modern titles are concerned, things that the rest of the world is playing, I don't really have a whole lot of that. But you know what I do have? I have a fucking lot of Nintendo games. Super Nintendo, N64, I got a stack of them. and the wherewithal as far as playing them. I could swear that there was supposed to be a Jiggy up here. That's why I came all the way up here. And the wherewithal while I'm playing them to not make myself look like a complete ass. You know, except for a couple of times playing this game where I'm like, I don't know where to go or what to do or how to play. Alright, I'm gonna go do this. Bam! Found my sled. I'll go practice for the big race now. See you, buddy. There it is. Jesus, he put it all the way down there for me? Grew up with the old Rareware games, therefore always happy to find streamers who are playing them. Yeah, man, I can't tell you how upset I am that I can't find my copy of Donkey Kong Country. Oh man, that's burning my biscuits something fierce. Who am I? What am I, Foghorn Leghorn? Is there a present? Where's the... Can I get what's in this tree before I turn on the lights? There's a present right there. Here's the notes. But I think there's... No, okay, I gotta turn the lights on. I also got to dig up a copy of Conker's Bad Fur Day because that'd make for a fun evening after I've had a few kind of stream talking about Rareware games. Oh shit! Aerial action with my devastating beak bomb attack. I thought you got this in Gobi Desert. Plus B to launch Kazooie at a target like a missile. Use your targets carefully because it costs a red feather each time you use it. My energy is a little low, thank you, bottles. And I've learned all the moves I can teach on this world. I love that the game makes no reservations about calling... like, having the characters reference the game. That's something that Rareware is really good at, is they're just self-referential enough to be funny. But not so much that you're like, oh, Jesus, with the fourth wall breaks already. You know, like, Gruntilda makes reference that you're playing a game. And, like, makes fun of you when you get a game over and all that. Okay, you're right. I can play Donkey Kong as a ROM. But I prefer not to emulate. And in fact, I'm playing this. I keep doing this. I'm playing this on an N64. Like, it's there. And I'm doing a capture for it. Because again, like, it feels more honest. It feels like I don't know really what the copyright laws are for, like, even owning ROMs or playing them on stream, especially not if I eventually go on to... I know that this isn't gonna happen. But if, in some weird reality, I go on to become a partnered Twitch streamer and I'm making revenue playing video games, I do not want to be in a situation where I'm playing ROMs. Okay. You know what I mean? Like, that just, it seems... So when I started the channel, I was using ROMs because I didn't have options, really. But my financial situation changed enough that I was able to... get a capture card and, like, an HDMI composite converter. Like, I've got this thing where... Because these older games, they didn't use... they didn't use HDMI, but the device I got to do game capture is HDMI only. It seemed like the best piece of technology for my needs at the time. So I got it, and I got a converter that converts, component or composite? I forget which. The one with the yellow, red, and white. Converts them to an HDMI signal so I can use them on an HDMI-capable device. It's a little buggy to get it set up, but it ends up working well for my purposes, which is to dick around in a video game. I don't, you know. And, like, ROMs are very common, and I don't have a problem with people that use ROMs. I just prefer to do it this way. I think it's... Oh yeah, I gotta slam those buttons, and I gotta power bomb into those snowmen. I got a lot of stuff to do in the air. Makes me more likable. That's nice. Oh, I can't do this until the lights are done. Oh, son of a bitch. Did I get the... How many presents do I have? It doesn't tell me, I don't think. And I can't look around, that's interesting. Fuck you! Oh, damn it! That hurt. That is nice of you to say, though, I appreciate it. Come on! Oh, God, get there! Yeah, it's a super common way to stream games. I'm fine with people who do it, I don't have a problem. You know, I'm not trying to sit here and go, oh, well, I do it the only correct way, and if you do it this other way, then that makes you a bad streamer, and you're dishonest, and you're all these things. No. Do what you gotta do. Do what you're gonna do. Have fun doing it. That's the main thing. This is about how I feel about something, personally. That's it. I would really like it if you stop hitting me with snowballs, you bastard. Okay, I don't want to transform yet. I've changed my mind. I am instead going to... Shit, I really thought that the third gift was around here somewhere. Did I already get the third gift? Did you see? Gotcha! Can I get there? Okay, good. I'm gonna go up and see if I... I'm gonna see exactly what I have here. Oh, you know what? I didn't even get the red gift out of the tree, did I? Jesus, I'm like completely... I'm a complete brain case in this level. Okay, you get a gift. And you guys don't get shit. Merry Christmas. Alright, Case, pull it together. You can do it, buddy. Red gift is inside the tree. The last present is in the cave? In the walrus cave? Okay. Fuck. Okay, I can do that then. I can't do that until after I've transformed though. Oh, I should kill that thing. Alright, gonna kill that. Here I go killing again. I just love killing. My name is Crumbobulus Michael. I'm about to make a point that I have made many times before, but you're new to the audience, so you get to hear it for the first time, as though I've never said it before. Ice levels are clever Ready? Are clever because they make the game suddenly more challenging because they change the control mechanics. Ice levels are clever because they make the game more challenging by changing the control mechanics. You spend the entire game learning how, up until the ice level, learning how to control your character, getting good at being precise with your movements and your jumping and all your whatnots. Then comes the ice level. It's usually 4 or 5 levels in. In Mario 3, it was World 6. I need that. I'm gonna go get that. In this, this is World 1, 2, 3, 4. It's World 5. Usually takes between 4 and 6 levels. How do I, there we go. You spend between 4 to 6 levels getting used to the controls, getting really good at jumping and moving and all that nonsense. Do I do that? Okay. And then in order to throw a monkey wrench into things without making the actual design of the level more complicated, they just make it so that it's harder to move. And you need to adapt. Super Mario 64 threw a little bit of a wrench in the works because one of their ice levels was like level 2 or 3. Like, they were real early with it. But the more movement into the, like, more running intense level was the later one. 1, 2, 3. Come on. One, two, three, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, like 10 levels in. Oh shit, what am I doing? Okay, that was close, but we made it. Now switch us on. Oh, fuck. Is that flying through? I think that's flying through the star. Nope. The desert level in Mario 64? Yeah. Oh, Jesus. I gotta go up there. Right? I have to go up there? No, I have to fly. Right? Yes, it seems like flight is the correct. Yeah, that's... It's not a challenging level if you know what to do and where the... Like, what the puzzles are. But it does have some of the more challenging puzzles, I agree. Like, the last star, you have to... Oh, shit. I'm not gonna do it. This is my last chance. Uh-oh. Last second, did you see that shit? It was brilliant. Nailed it. Like, I meant to do it that way. You have to climb up to the top of the inside of the pyramid, and then you have to, like, find the 5 hidden marks on the platforms. Very difficult. Knowing the puzzle, it's easy to do, but... How do you figure that shit out when you're a little kid? Not easy. I agree. Good level design, though. I actually just finished that level on Sunday. I do a show called Super Mario Sundays. I started in Mario 1, and I've played every Mario game I have up until and including Mario 64, which I am currently working on. It is... I have to do Dire Dire Docks, and then I'm done the basement. That's how far I am into it. My face was covering the counter. Oh, it was last second. I had 1 second left. Did I hit this yet? Yeah, I did, because it opened the little door out in the thing. Got it. Now what do I do? Now what do I do? What would I do? Hey, buddy. Right, I've been here before. Okay, I can go in there if I am a walrus. Or, can I go in there anyway? Can I go in there? No? That's what I thought. Okay. I have to slam the two buttons. Oh, that's where the Jiggy goes on his hat, because I slammed the buttons. Okay, I can do that. I gotta kill the rest of the snowmen. I gotta turn into a dude and go into the where. And do the what. Oh, there's the present. Found it! Nailed it. But I agree, I do have to go in there and get something. So I'm gonna do that now. There's something in here. Hey, Jinjo! I can hear him. I can hear his ass up there somewhere. I'm coming, buddy. Orange Jinjo is in the cave, I think, and I missed a note. Is that all the notes? Did I get all the notes? Did I get all the notes? I feel like I got all the notes. Andrew got all fat. Got big teeth. Yeah, you're no prize winner yourself there, Skull Kid. Oh yeah, alright, so I can wander around in here and get the notes that I need to get. Right? Is there notes? I thought there was... Invincibility Feather. I'm like 10 out of 10 sure that there's notes, right? Isn't there no- there they are. Oh shit, I'm almost done the notes. What if they're in the cave? What if they're in the cave, I said. Yes. We have to go to the cave. Mumbo ever turned me into the washing machine? Not in this playthrough. But yes, I have seen that happen. I don't know how to trigger it. I think there's like a thing I can do to make it happen. Is that right? Hey, buddy. Another walrus. Take this, but watch out for a smelly brown bear and his ugly bird partner. You got it, buddy. I will keep my eye out. I'll keep a weather eye, I promise. Alright. Hey, what's up, buddy? Hello again, Mr. Walrus. Feel free to have a look around Waza's cave. Alright, cool, 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 cool. Oh, I wanna get that! I wanna get it! Okay. So I guess I gotta come back in here as the dangerous duo. How many is that? Only one, okay. Alright, it would seem that my progress is somewhat stalled by the fact that I can't jump that high. Maybe now that I have his jiggy, he'll let me in as Banjo-Kazooie. Maybe. Let me up there. Alright, okay. What's the skinny on the, walrus race? Can I do that? Where do I sign up for that shit? Oh, I think it's over there. Take me to the kids, I'm the last one! That's useful, actually. I'm happy that he said that. Fuck! Dodge it! Start here? Yeah, it starts here, tight. Hey, Mr. Walrus. Let's do it. Yeah, let's do it. Okay, all you need to do is steer the sled through the red slalom gates. Beat me to the end. Let's do it! Faster than you. I'm a walrus. I'm the Eggman. Fuck out of here. Oh, there's my notes. Ah, no. I don't want to lose. Give me up here. Yeah. Yeah. Fun fact, if you're first, he goes faster. If he's first, he'll slow down. Oh, okay, so he uses Super Mario Kart rules. I could get the most bananas, like, just crush everybody kind of momentum happening in that game and in Mario Kart 64. And then they just show up behind me again, as though they were driving at Mach 5. It's the sort of thing a cheater would do. Damn cheaters. Hey, a Mumbo token. I think that's it. Right? For what I need to do as this thing I am? Right? I think? Maybe? I think. Oh, Christ. There's two notes somewhere? Oh. Thank you. I don't know how I feel about that. Maybe I missed some on the scarf or something. They can be hard to see. Come on, get up here. Dodge it. Did I miss the notes in the cold water? No, I got them. I thought... Oh shit, are they down here? In this water? No, there's a note. And there's a note. Okay, I found them. So they're next to the tree. When I land, I'll cruise over there and collect them. Right now, I got some targets to hit. I must have just... I went... You know what I did? When I went over to the tree, I approached from the right-hand side, and then left by the same side. You know what I mean? Like that. Where I should have gone all the way around. Okay, so now there's a note between his... or a jiggy between his legs. Let me see if I can get more snowmen to die at the hands of my devastating beak attack. There are more, right? Oh yeah, there's that guy over there. I killed all the rest of the snowmen? Doesn't seem like the sort of thing I've done. Son of a bitch. I have killed them all. Great! Good! Excellent. I will land here. Collect that. Do the thing. I gotta collect the note. Let me see. Don't forget anything. I gotta collect this. Gotta go up and give the kids the gifts. That way. Oh, you know what? I'm gonna grab the notes first. Gonna grab the notes first. There, that way if I fuck up, I'm good. Oh, you know what I should have done? I should have gone up to the top of the snowman. Because I had to stop by here to leave the level anyway. So I'm wasting a little bit of time in doing it this way, but... No worries. So now there's... the race that I need the sneakers for. The Jinjo, which is in the cave, and at the top of the hat, which I've already gotten. Am I at 7 right now? Okay. So I'm done the level, I just need to go collect my shit and leave. That'll be fine. These feathers will be helpful. Oh, come on. Where's the cave? Is it over here? No, that's where the race starts. Caves on that side. Eek! Oh, shit. I skipped his text or something. So there's the ice key, which was supposed to be... If I remember my Banjo-Kazooie backstory. Banjo-Tooie came out. And you were supposed to be able to... I feel like you were supposed to be able to save things between the two games and go back and forth with them. But the tech just wasn't there. I think that's what happened. The ice key... Let's try not to die, alright? That's like the hardest one. I want to say that the ice key was a part of that. But as it stands, it's actually quite useless. Hey! Some free health. Thank you for your contribution. We're gonna go up here. We did it! We are now finished Freeze Easy Peak until we can get the running shoes. Which is super duper tight, cool-y-o beans. Smooth. Oh, that was smooth. My best note for this world is now 100. It's not how you say 100 in Spanish, but I've actually forgotten how to say 100 in Spanish. Cien, I think. Siento? Siento. Okay, there's the jump pad. Here's the sneakers. Don't think you can use these until you've learned... Until you found out how. Okay, so I don't do that. That's... Okay. Right. So in order to get that jiggy that I unlocked, I need to use the running shoes to run all the way the hell over here. Use the flight pad that spawns right here and fly back into that room. This is not the path forward. Ow. What? Ow, fuck. Oh, This is the path forward. Oh shit, you know what I never did? I never turned into a crocodile and got the spellbook. Fuck. I gotta do that. I gotta go do that. I gotta go do that. Okay. Next time when Barf plays Banjo-Kazooie, in the next segment, we are going to Gobi Valley, grab the running shoes, and then leave. We're gonna head over to Bubble Gloop Swamp, get the alligator transformation, go get the spellbook, apply the cheat that we get from the spellbook, and then get the jiggy that we just unlocked from the whatchacallit. That's what we're gonna do next time on Barf Plays Banjo-Kazooie.